What's up, everybody? In a previous video, I talked about how to make an HTML5 audio playlist, and I got a lot of questions, and they were good questions. And they were things such as, how do I shuffle? How do I make it so it automatically repeats? How do I make previous track buttons? How do I style this player? Pretty much anything under the sun that relates to an HTML5 audio playlist, I got questions on. And I wasn't expecting to get about 100,000 views or however many crazy amount of views I got on that video. So I thought I would do a quick update video. Okay, so first, regarding styling this player, unfortunately, this is a thing that is included by your web browser. So let's say you wanted to make this white and the player itself blue or something like that. You can't actually do that. You need to set the width of this player to 0, and then you can essentially create images and links and things like that that actually trigger certain events when clicked on using JavaScript. You can actually style this built-in player. If you want to see a video specifically on that, I will make one if I get enough requests to in the comment section below. Okay, so as you can see, we have our player, which is very similar to the one in the last video, except now we have previous track, next track, and obviously, please don't just copy and paste this. Customize it. Show off your site. I'd love to see them if you want to send me an email, if you want to tweet them to me, if you want to comment down below. But just customize it however you want. So, taking a look at this player. So, if I hit play, it will automatically go ahead and play the next song. If I hit next track, it'll do that. And I can go back and whatnot. And let's say I want all of a sudden to shuffle. I can turn on shuffling. And now if I hit next track, it's going to play them in a random order. So that's exactly what we wanted, right? So how does this code work? It's actually pretty simple. So taking a look at our file, it's actually pretty similar to what we had before. We have our list of links. We have some new buttons, which instead of linking to a file, we're just going to put pound sign, meaning that nothing's there. And we're going to have an on-click event. And so we're going to do playlist.previousTrack. And that's going to obviously trigger a previous track. And why is it playlist? Well, that's what we called it down below. So if you customize this code, do so accordingly. So if this were called ABC123, you would do ABC123 up here, etc., etc. Okay, so we have all these different things. Of course, you can make buttons. You can make one for toggling loops if you wanted to, things like that. And of course, we include our code here. So here we have just commented out a list of the default constructor configurations, meaning if nothing is passed in here, which nothing is right now, what is the default configuration? Well, by default, we don't want to autoplay. Well, there is an exception to this rule. If this is set up here to autoplay, it will autoplay. But otherwise, by default, autoplay is going to be disabled. Shuffling is going to be disabled. Looping is going to be disabled, meaning once you play everything through once, it's just going to stop, okay? Player ID is up here. It is whatever this is. So audio player is a default with camel casing. Playlist ID is playlist. That's the ID associated with the list. Current class is a CSS class that automatically applies whenever this list item is the current class. So when soaring is the current track, current-song will be applied as a class to this list item. Okay, pretty straightforward, I think so anyways. Now, by default, like I said, we are not passing anything in. Yes, we have this config, but we're not actually passing it in. So if I go over here once again and refresh, it's not going to autoplay, even though I have autoplay enabled. Now, what we can do is we can, again, have some JSON, so that's JavaScript object notation, Google it, but basically it's pretty straightforward. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. What we can do is we can copy this config, we can paste it in here and hit save. So now if I go to the web page, you can see it auto plays and it's moving on to the next track. It just so happened that it picked the first track randomly to be the first one. So let me go ahead and pause that while we're working on that. So I'm not going to pass this in for now, but once again, you can customize this. So if you wanted to say playlist ID, you could do that. So just look at this. This is the default constructor arguments, okay? So if that's all you care about, this is going to be the end of the road for you. If you don't care about how the code works, that's fine, whatever. But for those of you that want to know more in depth of how they can customize it even further, they want to actually learn JavaScript in depth, stay tuned for the rest of the video. But if this is goodbye for you now, for now, make sure to hit that subscribe button, hit the bell notification icon so that way you're notified about new videos. You can also follow me on Twitter at Nels. And thanks for watching. Okay, moving on for those of you that actually bother to care about the video. Okay, so taking a look at our code. So let's look at the constructor, which is essentially what processes our player at the beginning. So first, we have class object, which is this. This essentially keeps the scope. Because this is a specific keyword, it references whatever you're specifically talking about. So if I click on a link, this is referring to the action of clicking on the link. In this case, this means the class itself. So by assigning it here, we're keeping the scope. Because if we go to our event listener, if we were to use this, it would think you're talking about the click. So class object is essentially keeping our scope, okay? Again, shuffling is disabled by default, but if shuffle is true, set it to true. Other than that, set it to false. And of course, we have it a bunch of times for different things. So basically, if it's passed through, so player ID, if it's passed through, it'll set it up. Otherwise, set it to audio player, etc., etc. So we just have this a few different times, okay? Moving on, we have the length, which is just the length of the player. So for instance, if there are 5 links in our HTML list, it will return 5. Next, we have player. Now, this dot player means that it's going to reference the player itself, okay? So let's say you want to pause, you would do playlist.player.pause, okay? So actually, that is a great time to bring up an important thing that everyone needs to know. So if you're using Chrome, go to the top right-hand corner, click on that link, go to More Tools, and hit Developer Tools. Go ahead and click on Console, and when I click on these things, excuse me, let me hit play, thank you, and whatnot, nothing is showing up, right? But what I can do is I can say console.log, and I can say test, and it will run. So you can actually do any JavaScript you want from here pretty much in manipulating the page after it loads locally, right? And this is a great way to test your code. So for instance, let's say, again, we're talking about the player. So I can do playlist.player.play because it's currently paused and it will play. So that's what I'm talking about when we're talking about that player is assigned that. So it's an easier way to access it, okay? So that's player. Autoplay, once again, by default, it's going to check if it's true and then set it to true accordingly. Or if autoplay is automatically configured based on the HTML5 tags, it will also set it to true. Otherwise, it's going to return false. Okay, moving on, loop. So if loop is set to true, otherwise set to false. Track position. Okay. This is where it gets a little bit complicated, and I've recorded this video probably like 10 times by this point. So basically, when you have an array stores items, and you can Google arrays to learn more about arrays, right? But basically, let's say you have a list of 5 things. You access them by what's called the index, okay? That's one way you can access them. But, which is essentially its position. But array start with 0. So let's say you have a list of 5 items. It will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay? So track position, meaning you're starting with the first one, but since it's off by 1, it's actually 0. Okay? Next, we want to create an array of our tracks in what order. So we want to create an empty array. And we are going to loop through every single track that's in our actual list right here. So if I go up top, and so we have this. So for each one, it's going to fill in as a value. So we have an array of, let's see, how many links do we have here? So 5. So at address 0, it's going to store the value of 0, meaning that within this index, it's an index of 0. So it's going to be 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Okay? It's going to seem a little bit weird, but it's going to make sense in a little bit. Next, we want to say if shuffled is enabled, randomize our array. So the values, we want to randomize the values that are stored in that array. Okay? So, for instance, and because those are indexes themselves. So, for instance, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 might become index 0. The values that are stored are index 0, then 1, then 4, then 3, then 2, or something like that. So, that's what that means. It's a little confusing because you're dealing with referencing and dereferencing arrays and things like that. So this really isn't an introduction to JavaScript. So if you're looking for an introduction to JavaScript, that's not this video. Look into arrays and things like that and indexes. Okay. Next we have set track, which is going to set it to 0. So regardless if it's shuffled or not, we want to set track to the first index in our array. And again, our index is storing indexes. So it's indexes being stored in indexes. And access or indexes. It's very confusing in that regard. Okay, so set track. So let's say the first track is the fourth element, which is going to be 3 in actuality in regards to its index, and that index is in position 0. So that's what's going to play, for instance, if that was the track that was selected. And then if, sorry, I've tried to make this video so many times, y'all don't even know. Okay, moving on. If this autoplay is set to true, go ahead and play. Okay, now we get into the fun things. But before that, let's go back to the top and talk about the set track function, because that's actually very important. So set track, let's say go up here. So we're passing in the array position, meaning the position of the index of our array of index, not the index referring to the HTML element, okay? So we need to essentially convert it into a format that references that HTML list. Then we're going to grab that source, insert it into the player's source. We are going to remove the current class from anything that's there and apply it to the right link, okay? And then we're going to update the track is position to match the array position, meaning again the array position index that stores our indexes of HTML indexes. Very confusing, I know. Okay, moving on. So handling links is actually pretty simple, and that's probably the most complicated part, is knowing which index you're dealing with. So if you don't know about indexes, you probably don't want to customize this, but it's still good to explain for those that want to essentially add a new function to this or something like that, okay? Because you easily could. Okay, moving on. We have handling link clicks. This is going to be a fun one. Sorry guys, we're already at like 14 minutes. I know. By default, when you click on a link, it's going to go to a file. But we're passing in the event and we're going to say, hey, prevent the default action, which is to go to the file. And next, we want to set the track to the index. And again, we need to do some kind of a conversion because we need to get it converted from the index that you're clicking on into the index as the position within that array. So that's what that is. Then we're going to go ahead and hit play. Okay. Now, moving on. Once the track has ended, we're going to say, hey, is this the last track? If this isn't the last track, we're going to set the track to the next track and hit play. Pretty straightforward. Else, if we're in a loop, meaning that if loop isn't enabled, this will not happen at all. None of this will happen. But if looping is enabled, we're going to go in here and we're going to say, hey, is shuffle enabled? Great, let's randomize the order. Because you don't want to play 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2. You might want 1, 3, 2, then 2, 3, 1, or blah, 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 blah. So it's going to randomize the list one more time. And it's going to go to the beginning of that new random list. And we're going to, of course, player. So that's pretty much it. We also have some things up top just to go over really quickly. Previous track, so if the previous track is the first track in our list of tracks, we're going to go to the very beginning. Otherwise, go back to a track, which is why it's the current position minus 1. Pretty straightforward right there. Next track, so if this isn't our last track in our list, go ahead and go to the next track. If it is the last track, if it is the next track, if shuffle is enabled, randomize the order once again and set the track to the first one in that list. So, once again, this is only applied to that, but it always is going to set that back to the beginning. And then going ahead and playing our player. Set loop is just updating variables. Set shuffle is going to look a little complicated, but it's really not. So if there's no change, just go ahead and return the value that was passed. If it is changed to true, well, now we need to randomize the order again, and we're going to set it to true. Now, if the order was previously set to, if we were passing that, we want it to no longer be shuffled, but we need to reorganize that array in the correct order, and that's what we're doing once again here. And of course, we want to jump to the correct position. So that's what this is doing. So let's say you randomize and you had a randomized array and you're on track 4 and you turn off randomizing the track order. You don't want to hit next and have it go to the very beginning of the playlist. That wouldn't make much sense. So that's what that does. And then, of course, we want to return the status of what is being shuffled. Toggle shuffle literally just is a shortcut to say, hey, if it's shuffled, if shuffle's currently set to true, change it to false and vice versa. Same thing with loop. And there we go. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification to be notified on future videos. You can also follow me on Twitter, be notified about future content, and to stay updated with me. If you've enjoyed that video, once again, you can also hit that like button. And if you've enjoyed it, make sure to comment down below. Let me know your thoughts on the video. And until next time, I will catch y'all later.